Leaf curling in chili pepper, capsicum, tomato, or any fruiting or flowering plants is one of the most common problems any gardener face. If not treated at very early stages of infection, the plant's growth will be stunted, and that will cause not only significant reduction in the yield but also result in a distorted food formation. Today's episode is all about curling leaves on your plants. We'll discuss what causes leaves to curl, how to control and treat that very efficiently. I also how I revive this affected plant from this condition to this. So let's begin. These are two chili pepper plants potted together in the same container. Despite of their vigorous growth, if you see closely, you will find most of the younger leaves are starting to curl. And due to this disease, the plants are not producing any flowers or buds, which they are supposed to do during this time of the year. Even though some buds formed earlier, they didn't get matured and gradually become dry and brittle like this. Some of the younger leaves are becoming yellow as well. These are clear signs of leaf curling disease. You can see the infection has spread to every branches of the plants. And if we don't treat them now, these plants won't produce any fruits and even they might die. So first, let's understand what causes the leaves to curl like this. The reason behind this could be many different problems. It could be pest or viruses or environmental stress. So we need to identify what's happening in our plants. First, let's see if this is due to the environmental problems or not. During very hot days of summer, due to low humidity in the air, sometimes paper leaves curl as a self-defense mechanism to protect themselves from the hot winds. If you spray cold water to keep the plant's tissues cooler, this could be solved. But this is not the case here. So next, check if this is due to the viral disease or not. Chili leaf curl virus are among the most common diseases in a climate, especially like India. They are primarily transmitted through white flies. Many additional factors like heavy rainfall, poor soil, presence of weeds, they all can favor the development of this viral disease. The most common symptom is that most of the leaves, no matter whether they are young or old, they will curl upward and the leaves will become smaller. You will notice the infection in the whole plant from top to bottom. Unfortunately, there are no treatments available for this viral infection. If you suspect a virus, you need to remove the infected plant or at least cut off the infected parts of the plant immediately. Now, if you see only some of the leaves are getting affected, then it is not virus. It is due to pest attack, which is the case for my plants here. Pests like aphids, thrips, mites and white flies can cause leaf curl due to their feeding activities. Depending on the pest and their location of the feeding, the leaves can curl upward or downward or randomly. For example, pests like thrips generally reside on the upper side of the leaves and feed from there. Due to that, the leaves curl upward like this. On the other hand, pests like mites, they reside on the lower side or the opposite side of the leaves and feed from there, making the leaves curl downward. If you notice leaves like this, downward curling, you can be sure this is due to the mites' attack. Sometimes thrips and mites can be present together and make the leaves randomly curled or twisted like this. Along with that, you will notice some of the young leaves are getting yellow and fall off very early stages. And this is the case happening here. We will start the treatment accordingly. Now for the treatment, let's look at the insecticides which can be used to treat this. These pest attacks which I mentioned, like due to the thrips, aphids, mites and white flies, they all can be prevented by regularly using neem oil. The neem oil I use is of 0.15%, that is 1500 ppm, which means parts per million. You can also find a 10,000 ppm neem oil, and that's the best for the plants. And remember that anything below 1000 ppm is of no use in gardening. Neem oil along with some hand wash or dishwashing soap can be used once in a week only for prevention and to treat some of the mild infections. There is another organic product named Kaka. You can also use that. It's good especially for controlling mites. But if somehow the disease spreads rapidly like this, then unfortunately it's very difficult to treat it in organic way. We need to use chemical pesticides for that. Although I won't recommend this for plants, especially for the vegetables or fruiting plants. But if you still want, you can use the right pesticide and treat the plant very easily. For thrips and aphids, we will use an insecticide with the chemical name imidacloprid. It is a systemic insecticide which directly hits the central nervous system of the insects, resulting paralysis and eventually they die. For mites and white flies, we will use a contact insecticide or miticide with the technical name spiromacifen. It is an excellent chemical which can attack those pests in all stages from eggs to adults of their life cycle, resulting in a very long-lasting control. Of course, there are other chemicals with similar activities to control thrips, aphids, mites and white flies. I will list them along with their chemical names in the description box below. We'll use both imidacloprid and spiromacifen, but not together, rather separately, as the modes of these two chemicals' action are different and might not be compatible with each other. For instance, today I am using imidacloprid 2 ml per liter and after 3 days I'll use spiromacifen 1 ml per liter. You can also use a stickering agent or a spreader like few drops of liquid soap along with this to make it more effective with a very long lasting effect. Spray thoroughly. Try to cover both top and bottom sides of all the leaves and branches. Always remember that you should spray insecticides after the sunset and also ensure that your potting media is not completely dry. It should be little moist during the application of pesticide. Try to cover every area of your plants. You can repeat the same schedule after 1 week if you see the pest still remains in your plant. In my experience, after 2 to maximum 3 doses, you'll see all the pests are gone. This is the update of the plants after just 1 week of applying those pesticides. You can see the plants are responding well. The new leaves they produce are much greener and healthier. In every branches, you can see lots of buds. We have successfully controlled the pest attacks. However, there remain some branches which cannot be completely cured, but any new growths are free from this infection and that will ensure a much higher yield from these plants. This is the current condition after a few more days. You can see lots of white flowers in the plants. All the branches are producing a number of flowers or buds. The plant overall looks much healthier. From now on, we will keep using neem oil in a regular basis, that is once in a week, and that will prevent any further infection. You can also see some of the flowers become foods, these tiny little peppers. We can expect 100 of chilies from these two plants. In a separate video, I'll show how to get maximum chilies from your plants, that is their fertilizers and every other requirements. That will be all for today. If you find the video useful, please like, comment and share. And also don't forget to subscribe my channel if you are new here. Thank you for watching and see you next time in a brand new episode at Grow and More.